On agenda today, can teachers and activists thousands of kilometers away be booked for the murder of a man in Sukma, Chhattisgarh? The Buxar police have done just that, booking a Delhi University and a JNU professor, saying that the victim's wife heard the killers, who are Maoists, say that he was being killed because he didn't listen to the teachers advocating for the Maoists when they visited in May. Yes, it's a complicated story. We'll be playing out an interview with the IG Police of Buxar, SRB Kaluri, in just a bit. We have one of the teachers, Professor Archana Prasad, in studio with us. She is a JNU professor. We'll be speaking to her about how she now feels about being a murder suspect in the eyes of the Chhattisgarh police. And we also have with us in studio Ian Ram Mohan. He used to be the Director General of the BSF and has written and studied the way of the police and the Maoists in Chhattisgarh. But first, here's how Nandini Sundar reacted to it. She happens to be the petitioner in a Supreme Court case when it banned vigilante groups like Salwa Jadum in Chhattisgarh.
I mean, the whole thing is so absurd. It's so patently malafied that, you know, I really don't know what to say. I don't even remember who this Baghel is. I'm sorry, I'm not. I'd have to look at my field notes. So what actually happened was that the villagers then had formed this Tangya gang, and so we said, fine, you should. They were asking us what they should do, and we said, yeah, you just, you know, be sure you're independent, because both sides are dangerous for you. So the police have described that as incitement, that, you know, if they didn't support the Maoists would burn their houses. It's how ridiculous can that be, that we would go around saying things? The villagers said that they had not filed any complaint. So it was clearly a trumped up false complaint by the police in May to say that we intimidated the villagers. And, you know, for them to now say that we are the ones who were in any way responsible for the killing of Shyamnath Baghel is absurd.
So that's the Delhi University professor who's been booked for murder. The JNU professor, Professor Archana Prasad, is here with us. Professor Prasad, how do you react to this? The trip that you made with Nandini Sundar in May, the police now says that's where you conspired to murder Baghel, and they say that his wife has given a statement saying she heard the killers say that they were killing him, Shyamnath Baghel. They were killing him because he didn't listen to what you all had told the villagers to do, which is to listen to the Maoists.
Well, I completely second what Nandini has said. She has explained the circumstances and the field trip that we undertook. I think it should be well understood that Nandini and I have been associated with Buxar for many, many, many years. We worked there as students much before any of the people who are charging us today were there. And we have seen the plight of the Adivasis. Successive governments have ignored the Adivasis and their plight. And you see, to put cases like this, first of all, the case should not be seen in isolation. This case should be seen as a part of a larger trajectory of events that has not only been taking place in Chhattisgarh, but after Chhattisgarh, the country as well.
Do you remember the Shyamnath Baghel?
No.
Not at all?
No. In my field notes, I don't even have his name.
And you looked at your field notes?
Yes.
And was there any complaint by any of the villagers?
No.
There was no conversation with the villagers?
No.
Because Nandini Sundar talks about the
There was a conversation. The villagers called a meeting and they explained to us what they meant. And we actually said that it's good that you are becoming self-reliant. But so don't listen to any of the two, because both the sides are exploiting you. And as far as my work is concerned, I think I've published enough to sort of propagate my democratic credentials. If the case ever comes up for hearing, I can produce all that. I am not worried.
Professor Prasad, okay, let's just hear what IGP Kaluri said about on what basis he's filed this case against the two professors and eight other people, including activists. SRP Kaluri, thank you very much for speaking to NDTV. Now, senior lawyers and others are condemning this FIR against Delhi academics who were not even in Chhattisgarh at the time of the murder. They, in fact, visited 6 months ago. How do you respond?
I would want to tell them that the people of Bastar and people of Chhattisgarh and the patriots are jubilant. They are overjoyed that police has become very active and it is taking right steps in the right direction. Okay, there may be diverse points of view. A murder has taken place. Okay, you have to keep in mind it's a very grievous offense and the murdered has expressed apprehension prior to the murder itself that if something were to happen to him, these people would be responsible. There has been a threatening, there has been a conspiracy, there has been a clear case of murder. It is both the ways. If the human rights activists and some NGOs are unhappy, by and large, a common man is very happy, especially a Bastarite, that police is taking right steps in the right direction.
So, sir, you're saying that Shamnath Baghel, who's the deceased, left a note saying that if anything happens to him, that they are responsible.
It's not a note. No. You please stand corrected. It's not a note. It was a written complaint. It was a complaint put up in the police station and correspondence has been made to their universities also and to the governments and ministries. There is a background. It's a clear and deliberate act of offense. There has been conspiracy. There has been intention, act, preparation. We are quite convinced that a very grievous offense has taken place and we would be happy if security agencies and police are let free to investigate into the matter and we'll put up all the facts and evidences before the court of law. I don't believe in parallel investigations and media trials. We go by Indian Penal Code, we go by the CRPC, we go by the Evidence Act, we have laws, we have acts, we are a specialized agency. We would be very happy if parallel investigations and media trials are put to an end because tribals are getting killed. You have to keep in mind that Shamnath Baghel, he is a tribal and also he is a member of Darbha Block Congress Committee. He is a member of a mainstream political party. He has been killed in front of his family. He has been brutally butchered. Eyewitness are his wife, his four children, his mother and father. We have a written complaint to this effect. An FIR is registered. Now a special team will be constituted which will look into this investigation of this case. It will be investigated into very impartially, very thoroughly. And it would be better if security agencies are let to function independently so that killing of tribals comes to an end in Bastar.
You said that you've written to the vice chancellors. What did you say to them?
See, Nandini Sundar, according to us, is a suspect. Okay? Her behavior has been suspicious right from the beginning. We have been communicating to her Vice Chancellor, we have been communicating to the concerned ministries, concerned government. I don't want to go by what Nandini Sundar says. She is a suspect. She is a suspect in the eyes of the police. Let law take its own course. She is not above board.
So
Nandini Sundar is a common suspect and she will be treated accordingly.
But sir, what did you tell the Vice Chancellor?
Next course of action is the case will be handed over to a special team which will explore all the options available. We want to take recourse to the strictest possible action. There is a popular government in Chhattisgarh. There is a popular government at Delhi. We don't want any remote controlling from outside. Let the bureaucracy work. Let the police agencies work. Let the security agencies work. Let democracy take its course. Let us follow the Constitution of India. Let us follow the rule of law. Let Bastar not be remotely controlled.
You've written, sir, to the university and ministry. Have they allowed you to proceed in this matter?
The local SPs have been continuously writing to the vice chancellors, they have been writing to the governments, they have been writing to the ministries. We have mailed all the correspondence, we have got some queries also, we have answered the queries. We are yet to see what action the university takes.
But sir, why are activists the enemy?
Activists are enemies because they incite people against democracy. They incite Basterites against rule of law. They incite people against parliamentary democracy. They question the sovereignty of India. They question the universality of India. They question the existence of India. That's why we oppose the activists. How can the activists, on one hand, they stay in a democracy, they enjoy the benefits of parliamentary democracy, they question the constitution, they reject the rule of law, the parliamentary democracy. So the both cannot go hand in hand. That's why we oppose only those who run the Hate India Brigade. We oppose those who issue fashion statements against democracy. We oppose anti-national brigades. That's it. Activists who want to work for tribals are most welcome. We are going to welcome them with both hands. You cannot enjoy the benefits of Indian democracy and run anti-national brigade. You cannot issue fashion statements against India. You cannot be a member of anti-national brigade. This we don't accept.
Okay.
You work for the tribals, you work for Bastar, you work for democracy. We welcome you with both hands.
So that was IGP Kaluri speaking to us, NDTV, earlier in the day. How do you want to say anything about what he said?
Of course. I think his last statement gives away everything. It shows that he's acting as the handmaiden of a right-wing, fascist, semi-fascist government. And it shows that he is himself not bothered about the Constitution of India, because the Chhattisgarh government has continuously violated the Constitution of India, continuously, whether it's the Supreme Court directives on Salwa Judum, whether now that the CBI has filed charge sheets,
yes,
in the Taj Mirza case.
Just 2 weeks earlier.
Yeah, now they are sensationalizing it to divert attention. So who is anti-India? They are anti-tribal, not us.
So, we are also joined by Himanshu Kumar, an activist from Chhattisgarh and one of those whose effigy was burned by security forces. Himanshu Kumar, you heard what the IGS said. How do you see this case against the academics?
देखिए शुरू से अगर आप देखें इस केस को तो जो FIR कह रहे हैं कि सामनाथ बघेल ने नंदिनी सुंदर और अर्चना प्रसाद और बाकी एक्टिविस्ट के खिलाफ दी थी, वो थाने के मुंशी के द्वारा लिखी गई थी। वो सामनाथ बघेल पढ़े लिखे नहीं थे। ये पुलिस ने खुद उस वक्त शिकायत बनाई थी एक्टिविस्ट के खिलाफ, क्योंकि एक्टिविस्ट वहां गए थे कुछ मामलों की जांच करने के लिए। ये मामला इन्होंने ही बनाया था। अब वहां बस्तर में कत्ल होते हैं, नक्सली भी हैं, पुलिस भी है, दोनों कत्ल करते हैं, किसी का उनमें से कत्ल हो गया, उसका फायदा उठाकर उस कत्ल का दिल्ली में बैठे हुए लोगों को फंसाना, और ऐसे वक्त में जबकि कल्लूरी साहब के खिलाफ खुद सुप्रीम कोर्ट में सीबीआई की रिपोर्ट फाइल हुई है अभी कि उनके नेतृत्व में गांवों को जलाया गया, बलात्कार किए गए और हत्याएं करी गईं। कल्लूरी साहब पूरी तरह से फंस गए हैं और फंसे हैं नंदिनी सुंदर के केस में सुप्रीम कोर्ट में।
okay.
तो ऐसे वक्त में कल्लूरी साहब के इंटेंशन पर डाउट पूरी तरह से हो सकता है कि वो चाहते हैं कि एक तो खुद बच जाएं, दूसरा नंदिनी को पलटकर फंसा दें।
जी जी,
तो ये तो पूरा केस शुरू से ही अच्छा। सामनाथ बघेल वगैरह को इन्होंने टंगिया ग्रुप बनाया था कल्लूरी साहब ने। एक तो ये कल्लूरी साहब वगैरह संविधान को बिल्कुल कुछ समझते नहीं है। टंगिया जानती है, कुल्हाड़ी ग्रुप क्या है?
It's like a self-help
group. जो तुमको लगे कि ये व्यक्ति नक्सली समर्थक है उसको कुल्हाड़ी से काट दो। तो ऐसा एक गुंडा समूह कल्लूरी साहब ने बनाया था, अब ये भी लोगों को मार रहे हैं और किसी ने इनको मार दिया.
ओके
तो उसमें नंदिनी सुंदर को क्यों बीच में फंसा रहे हो?
सो मिस्टर राम मोहन, यूव एज अ पुलिस ऑफिसर, यू हैव सीन ओवर देयर, डू यू सी द एविडेंस? हाउ डू यू असेस द एविडेंस? बिकॉज दे आर गोइंग बाय अ कंप्लेंट दैट वाज मेड इन मे. दिस इज नाउ 6 months लेटर एंड एज अर्चना प्रसाद इज सेइंग, why if there really was a complaint against me which the police found was credible, why didn't they question me earlier?
I wouldn't be able to talk something about this particular case because I am not aware of all the facts in this case, but as you say, the FIR was prepared after 6 months of the incident.
Well, the FIR, this FIR is after the murder, which was on Friday.
Acha, it was done immediately after the murder. I have been speaking and writing about this particular problem. I wouldn't be able to give any opinion about this case because I do not know the facts of the case. Just a simple surface thing, it appears automatically that the whole bloody thing is fixed up. But I want to tell one particular thing, and I have been writing about this for the last 20 years. It's not just this moment or last couple of years. The state government and the central government are violating the Constitution of India in not giving rights to the Adivasis. The fifth schedule very clearly says it is the tribal who will form a committee and administer their areas. Nobody is talking about the fifth schedule. They are simply going and mining this area, and naturally the Maoists have got round and organized the tribals.
Is it the police versus civil society in Chhattisgarh
now? It is not the police, it is the very government, the state government itself, all the state government and even the central government. The fifth schedule is so very clear. It says it is the governor of the state who will administer the scheduled areas of the state, and an act has been enacted to facilitate this particular article of the constitution. The governor of the state will administer the scheduled areas of the state where the tribals live. What does it mean? It means the state government has no role. It is only the governor who is doing it.
So
who should do it?
Professor Prasad,
why is it that not a single governor is doing his job?
Sure. Professor Prasad, what is going to be the next course of action for all of you who've been booked? Is it, do you challenge this now? How do you
see, first we have to get some communication. Means the police only communicates through Facebook and through the media. This is what has been happening since the beginning of the so-called case, whatever it is. I mean, so there is allegedly a case against me, but somebody has to tell me that there is a case against me, number one. Number two, they wrote to my university earlier also. My university saw the nature of the complaint and decided it wasn't worth pursuing.
Right, that's what he was talking about in the interview.
Yeah, so if he's trying to intimidate my university into pursuing the case, then you know what the situation in JNU is. They are anyway going to target everybody as an anti-national.
Himanshu ji, is case ka koi fark padega baaki jo activists hain, kyunki unhone hamare interview mein keh diya ki activists jo hain wo agar jo Bastar mein hame aise log nahi chahiye.
देखिए, सबसे बड़ी दिक्कत की बात यही है कि बस्तर में एक तरफ तो ये पुलिस फोर्सेस जाकर आदिवासी महिलाओं के साथ बलात्कार कर रहे हैं, बड़ी संख्या में बलात्कार हुए हैं, निर्दोष लोगों की हत्याएं कर रहे हैं, बच्चों तक को मार रहे हैं. ऐसे में आदिवासियों की मदद करने वाले लोगों को रोक दिया जाएगा, डरा दिया जाएगा कि तुम्हारे को हम फर्जी केसों में फंसा देंगे, वकीलों को वहां से भगा दिया जा रहा है, कोई मदद नहीं कर सकता आदिवासियों की, तो जनता तो बिल्कुल अनप्रोटेक्टेड हो जाएगी, मुसीबत में फंस जाएगी. सोनी सोरी वहां मदद करती है, सोनी सोरी के मुंह पर ये कल्लूरी साहब तेजाब फेंकवा देते हैं. मैं साफ कह रहा हूं, कल्लूरी साहब सुन रहे हैं, तो कल्लूरी साहब ने सोनी सोरी के मुंह पर तेजाब फेंकवाया. हमारे पास सबूत है, गवाह है हमारे पास.
ठीक है. But what is evident is that this case will continue. We'll see perhaps lots of follow-ups to it. Archana Prasad, we'll keep tracking the story as well. And as you say, you're not deterred by this.
Why should we be deterred? We have been advocates of Adivasi rights for all our life. Are we going to leave our conviction because some government wants to intimidate us? We are not going to do that.
Okay. Right. Professor Archana Prasad speaking up about the case that the Chhattisgarh police have booked against her and other academics and activists as well. Thank you very much to all my guests for joining us here on Agenda. We'll be back again. Join us again. Goodbye.